गवर्नमेंट ऑफ ओडिशा हैज टू चेंज जो सेकेंडरी रेफरेंस प्रोविजन कराला एवं जेएसएस के रे हमने जो बता भी देखो छु अधिक पैसा सो सम ऑफ द रिजल्ट्स हम ऑफ एडवोकेसी रे हैव अ बियरिंग एवं सरकार ताकू माननी के सरकार लेवल पे पॉलिसी चेंज छु वी आर रियली प्राउड कहीं ना सरकार रे गोटे पॉलिसी बा गोटे नीतिगत निष्पत्ति जत बे निया जाए based on some solid evidence and we have tried to create that pressure so you think I mean it's sure samaste proud je we are a part of an alliance jo mane ma manko pai ami kichhi kori parchu before we introduce ourselves I think I will request Dr. Sen from UNICEF kana se white man alliance ro odisha re starting re UNICEF has been our partner hand-holding partner, I would say, and Dr. Sen has been involved with us from the very beginning. know more. Dr. Sen ko kahi bhi se jo some initial thoughts, some initial moments with the Y21 lens and some because Dr. Sen jo policy documents se itna takho ne ki sarkar ko sign kare ko sarkar ko adhikari man se alochana karte the. So some of the thoughts, how those advocacies were done, I mean with lot of conviction and lot of results to share that. Then आमे district perspective रे किसी किसी हमारा experience आने में then we think how we can use the law really to really benefit the women to have real safe month. Dr. Sen, Dada.
Good afternoon, respected delegates. I hope I can speak in English or I need to speak in Odia. Way back in 2004, when the Odisha was having a very high maternal mortality ratio as well as infant mortality rate, we had two milestone programs in our state. One is that infant mortality reduction mission, which was actually led by our Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Naveen Patnaik ji, and I think it delivered result in terms of reducing the infant mortality rate in our state by almost 34 points over a period of 7 years. I think that's the largest or fastest decline in infant mortality rate in the whole country, and I think we got a very good evidence that political will can make a significant difference when they want to make it. So, looking at the success of the infant mortality reduction mission, the state of Odisha, under the leadership of Family Planning Association of India at that time, tried to convene a Safe Motherhood Alliance in the form of White Ribbon Alliance of India. When White Ribbon Alliance of India was formed in the state, we had various types of partners, ranging from various civil society organizations to bilateral donors, UN agencies like UNFPA, UNICEF, and UNDP at that time. We also had several international NGOs like CARE, CRS, ActionAid, all together coming to form that Safe Motherhood Alliance in the state. And we could make a very good start with the blessings of the then governor that the Safe Motherhood Alliance chapter was created in 2004. Subsequent to that, on every April 11th, then Kasturba Gandhi's death day. In Odisha, we always have an interaction at the policymakers level as well as in the district by the Safe Motherhood, by the White Ribbon Alliance of India. It's also worth mentioning that amongst various state bodies of White Ribbon Alliance, Odisha's White Ribbon Alliance has the expanse up to 30 districts, so all the districts has a member of White Ribbon Alliance, and we also have reached out to around 314 blocks in Odisha. So for White Ribbon Alliance, we have a partner in all the districts, we have a partner in all the blocks. Now, as Mr. Vishwajit Pari was mentioning, that one of the things that the same White Ribbon Alliance had conceptualized, we had gone through a strength, weakness, opportunities and threat or SWOT analysis of the organization, and we came up with the things that White Ribbon Alliance can do and what should the other partners of White Ribbon Alliance provide support. We learned that White Ribbon Alliance has a very strong advocacy potential with the media, to be precise, with the legislators, because many of our block members or many of our district members are very close friends of the legislators of Odisha. So as priority advocacy activities of White Ribbon Alliance, we try to build up partnership with media as well as with the legislators, and had several interactions with them highlighting the safe motherhood issues and what should be done by the media and the legislators to ensure that maternal mortality in our state comes down. Number two is, when the White Ribbon Alliance was formed, we had to share different roles and responsibilities, and UNICEF as a partner of White Ribbon Alliance of Odisha worked with White Ribbon Alliance in three major areas. One is trying to find out the strength, weakness, opportunities and threat of the agency. In the initial day, support the organizational capacity building of White Ribbon Alliance members. And third is to work with the White Ribbon Alliance. Critical social observations which we collected together through our maternal and perinatal death inquiry. In terms of the biological causes, three or four important observations that came up. Number one is that mother continues to fall ill and die at home. They do not die in the institutions. Whereas that means that when we are claiming as 82% of institutional delivery, but it became very clear that the mothers are either not encouraged to stay because of the infrastructural deficiency, or there is no cultural practice in the community, because pregnancy is a physiological function. So many women still now, whenever we go to the field, that the women has just come out of her labor room, the baby is in the lap of either mother-in-law or mother, I mean the mother's mother-in-law or mother's mother, but the husband is ready to call an auto or call a jeep because he wants to go back. He came with his other siblings, her in-laws or her mother, and the pregnant woman all together came in an auto or a jeep which is waiting outside because they don't have the money to stay in that institution for 48 hours. So we find that non-stay of the women in the first 48 hours is a critical gap in terms of the biological cause, because they go back to house and then they die at house.